Zeal Education Society, redefining excellence.
Hi, let me start by introducing myself. I am Omkar Kale, and I am currently in third year of Diploma of Computer Engineering from Zeal College of Engineering and Research Pune. I completed our micro project with 7-7 and Amit Power under the guidance of Ms. Dipali Parsiman. Our micro project topic is entrepreneurial development and its impact on our economy. First of all, what is entrepreneurial development? Entrepreneurship development is the process of improving the skill and knowledge of entrepreneurs through various training and classroom programs. The whole point of entrepreneurship development is to increase the number of entrepreneurs. The whole point of entrepreneurship development is to increase the number of entrepreneurs. By doing this, the pace at which new business or ventures are made gets better. On a wider level, this makes room for employment and improves the economic of business or country. This is the process of entrepreneurial development. First, we discover the business, then developing the business plan, then gathering the resources, then managing company, and the last one is harvesting. The below mentioned step will illustrate how to build an effective entrepreneurial development program for entrepreneurs to organize and launch new ventures. First, discovery. An entrepreneurial process deals with the idea generation, wherein the entrepreneur identifies and evaluates the business opportunity. The identification and the evaluation of the opportunity is a difficult task. An entrepreneur seeks inputs from all the persons, including employees, consumers, channel partners, technical people, etc., to reach to an optimum business opportunity. Once the opportunity has been decided upon, the next step is to evaluate it. Then second is developing the business plan. Once the opportunity is identified, an entrepreneur needs to create a comprehensive business plan. A business plan is a critical to success of any new venture thing. It acts as a benchmark and evaluation criteria to see if organization is moving toward its set goal. Third is resourcing. The third step of entrepreneurial development is resourcing, wherein the entrepreneur identifies the resource from where the finance and the human resource can be arranged. Here the entrepreneur finds the investor for its new venture and its personnel to carry out business activities. Fourth is managing the company. Once the funds are raised and employees are hired, the next step is initiate the business operations to achieve the said goals. First of all, an entrepreneur must be decided the management structure or hierarchy that is required to solve the optional problems where they arise. Fifth is harvesting. The final step of entrepreneur's process is harvesting, wherein entrepreneur decides on the future of prospect of the business, that is its growth and development. Here the actual growth is compared against the planned growth, and then decision regarding the stability or expansion of business operation is undertaken accordingly by entrepreneur. Entrepreneur development is a cycle, the combination of support activity and help for development of entrepreneurship to sustain and stimulate in the community. Entrepreneurial development life cycle. First is stimulatory. Stimulatory is of entrepreneurial education, planned publicity for entrepreneurial opportunities, identification of potential entrepreneurs through the scientific methods, motivational training to new entrepreneurs, help and guidance in selecting products, and prepare project reports, J6 making available technical information and product profiles, evolving locally sustainable new products and processes, availability of a local agency with trained personnel for entrepreneurial counseling and promotions, organizing entrepreneurial forum. Second is the support, registration of a CV, arranging finance, providing land, share power, water, etc., guidance for selecting and obtaining machinery, supply for secure raw material, getting license or import license, providing common facilities, granting tax relief or other subsidies. Third is sustaining. Sustaining means health modernization, health diversification or expansion or substitute production. Defining repayment and interest. Define repayment and interest. Diagnostic industries, extension trusted source. Production units, legislation, policy change, reservation, creating new areas for marketing. Or testing and improving service. Need-based or controlling facility center. Type of entrepreneur. This is classification according to type of business. Means business entrepreneur, trading entrepreneur, industrial entrepreneur, corporate entrepreneur, and agriculture entrepreneur. The second classification is according to use of technology. Means technical entrepreneur, professional entrepreneur, non-technical entrepreneur, high technical entrepreneur. The third classification is according to motivation of entrepreneur. Means pure entrepreneur, induced entrepreneur, motivated entrepreneur, spontaneous entrepreneur. The next is classification of according to growth. Means growth entrepreneur and super growth entrepreneur. And the last classification is according to stages of development. Means first generation entrepreneur, modern entrepreneur, and classical entrepreneur. Role of entrepreneurship in economic growth. Rate of economic progress of the country depend upon the rate of innovations, which in turn depend upon the distribution of entrepreneurial talent in the population. Entrepreneur initiate and sustain the process of economic development is the following way. First is capital formation. Second is improvement in the capital income. Third is generation of employment. Fourth is balanced regional development. Fifth is improvement in living standard. Sixth is economic independence. And seventh is backward and forward linkage. The conclusion is that to be successful in the sustainable business, practice often requires entrepreneurship and innovation. This chapter provides an overview of entrepreneurship and innovation as it relates to sustainable business. The description is the most relevant to sustainable business. Focus on offering new products and service in response to societal concerns. The importance of entrepreneurship and innovation also applies to companies, then change how they produce products and services. The latter companies can be innovative practice on entrepreneur to establish their brand name and be market leaders in doing things that create shared value for society and their companies and also over time contributes to change in practice in their industries. Thank you.